We are kicking off from 61.49, the PSE index underperforming Asian peers on Wednesday on a confluence of headwinds. That's from oil rallying to 10-month highs to investors gearing up for that August CPI print from the U.S., which, as expected, showed an uptick. For more on the markets, Christina Gabaldon joins us live. Hi, Christina. Welcome back to Market Edge.
Hi, Mimi. Nice seeing you again.
Good to see you. Now wearing a different hat with Metrobank Trust. So let's start with the big event from overseas. With the U.S. CPI print of 3.7% headline, 4.3% core for August, you know, do you expect investors to sell on the news?
Well, I think some risk-off happened already before the CPI print. With the CPI print coming out, the CPI month-on-month came in at 0.6%, and the largest contributor of that would be gasoline. As you know, crude oil is trading at $89.54 per barrel right now, and also the shelter index or rent levels. So for us, things seem to be within expectation, though headline inflation is slightly ahead. Core inflation for us is manageable. If you look at hike probabilities, we're seeing a pause in September and November, but you know, rates could still remain at high levels.
Mm-hmm. All right, and too early to be talking about a cut. So if you feel that a sell, you know, risk off has happened already, selling on news, are you seeing any buy the rumor opportunities then?
Rumor or opportunities for the Philippine market? Mm-hmm. There's quite a number. Mm-hmm. So because of the MPI tender offer, MPI would be taken out of the PSEI index, and a name that would come and join the top 30 would be Bloom. Mm-hmm. Also, another name we're looking at is Union Bank. If the SSS stake is considered as non-free float, UBP could also be taken out of the index and CNPF would replace it. On FTSE, the effectivity date is September 15. AP is a name for deletion with 95 times average daily value turnover. AP's float is currently at 20.03%, and you know the threshold to join the index, it should be at 20%. So if it goes down below that come Feb, it might be taken out to be replaced by nickel.
All right.
Quite exciting.
Exciting indeed, considering the disclosures have been very quiet. There are exciting things happening under the radar. So going back to, you know, not specific stocks, but when you look at where inflation is today, where rates could stay higher for much longer than what we all expected, are earnings estimates now getting revised, maybe lower, given stickier than expected inflation? And as I mentioned, the higher for much longer prospects for interest rates. Are you revising down your earnings estimates?
Okay, so for 2023 earnings estimates, our expected earnings growth is at 15%. Our index target for this year is 6,900. For 2024, our expected earnings growth is quite conservative at just 6%.
Wow.
And our index target is 7,700. With inflation, we think consumer company margins could expect some contraction. Mm-hmm. It really depends on what inputs they have. Wheat prices have been going down, but oil prices have been rising. And in the news today, siling labuyo is at 500 to 720 pesos.
Yeah, can you believe that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and consumer companies, the manufacturers are 10% of the index.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Also, yeah. So with high inflation and interest rates remaining elevated, we expect things to be high for longer. This would affect the borrowing of companies. So they might delay their big ticket borrowings, their expansion or capex, you know.
Wow. So you're thinking that things could actually get worse next year. I mean, 6% earnings growth for next year on average. Is that what? Like the weakest in how many years?
The thing that concerns us is that top line growth for companies is quite slow at single digit, and this might translate to lower earnings come early 2024. So, yeah, some things need to happen before we become more bullish in the stock market.
All right. Going now to some interesting corporate stories. Very few that we're having since earnings season is done. Let's start with this. Globe Telecom confirming reports it is partnering with a global insurtech company called Boltec, which is supposed to launch a program that will make it easy for postpaid mobile device switching. Just very quickly, Globe Telecom, are you liking it? Whether it's valuation wise or growth perspective?
I think the telcos are facing a lot of challenges. One would be the CapEx and, of course, competition from each other. It's good that Globe is having this sort of innovation. It's like a gadget insurance. And yeah, it depends on the individual's circumstance, their lifestyle, whether their unit is expensive or not, and how they use it,
So from Globe, there's another interesting one, PhilInvest REIT. They just won sustainability, a Global Sustainability Leadership Stevie Award. But more than the award, I wanted to get your take on REITs. Do you think in this kind of environment, REITs offer an attractive proposition?
right? Right now, the concern with REITs, it's mostly offices, and the vacancies are in the double digit, and expectation next year's vacancy of around 20%. So yeah, those are the challenges for that.
So not too
Despite
hot about
the
REITs.
yes,
All right.
but maybe if the REIT companies diversify, if they have mall businesses that they could inject to it, since malls are doing better, maybe it could help.
All right. Well, that's a big maybe. I just wanted to bring in the opening numbers. We're about 7 minutes into trade for the day. The PSE index is on the up, joining most Asian peers. The index is up by 0.1%, 6 points, 61.55. The broader all shares, though, is down by 0.1. Looking at the sub-indices, it's a mixed picture. You've got financials, property, mining, and oil. Interest rate sensitive stocks in the negative territory, industrials, holding firms, and services marginally higher, at least for the first 7 minutes of trade for the day. Christina, I think we are ready for your blind item, this stock that you are watching closely and that you like. Don't tell us, just describe. We're going to leave our viewers to guess what this is. What do you have for us today?
Okay, so it is a property company. It is one of the largest integrated property developers in Southeast Asia that offer innovative and sustainable lifestyle cities through developments of malls, residences, hotels, and convention centers. The company made 30 billion last year and looks on track to beat that strongly this year. And with the pandemic done and dusted, the company has returned to its growth trajectory with new property developments and brand partnerships. It is also one of the biggest retail shopping center operators in the country. There are indications of stronger than expected 3Q performance for its malls business, driven by school openings and strong restaurant revenues. This could come as a surprise because 3Q is seasonally weaker. The stock price reversed course sometime August because of some regulatory pressure, which we think they can overcome. So this company is trading at a 60% discount to its NAV estimates, and we see a 24% upside to our to the name, and we think this company is prime for the picking.
24% upside in share price. How patient will an investor have to be to get that 24% upside? How long?
Hopefully a year.
A year. All right, 24%, 12 months. Sounds decent. We're just going to have to guess which stock this is. Although, with the clues that you gave, it's an easy giveaway. But let's see. They usually tweet us. Thank you so much, Gabs, for joining us this morning. Always a pleasure speaking with you. See you soon.
Thanks, Mimi. Bye.
All right.